Weld design, getting started. Weld design allows you to model welds in assemblies. The application offers a highly productive and intuitive design environment, providing different tools to fulfill your weld fabrication needs. This tutorial provides a step-by-step scenario aiming at giving you a feel of what you can do with weld design. It is composed of the listed tasks showing you key functionalities. Entering the workbench. The first task shows you how to enter Weld Design Workbench. Open a Catia session. Select the Start. Mechanical Design. Weld Design command. The Weld Design Workbench is displayed and an empty CAD product document opens. Select File. Open to open a selection dialog and select the Weld CAD product document. You can download the files from the link in the description. Please extract all files in the same folder. This assembly will be displayed. Creating a fillet weld. This task shows you how to create a fillet weld and the corresponding annotation. From the menu bar, open View. Render Style. Customize View menu item. Check the materials option to be able to see the material you will assign to the weld. This task must be performed using the default creation mode for weld. Click the fillet weld icon. The fillet weld creation dialog box appears. Enter weld 1 as the new name for the fillet weld in the weld name field. Enter 5 mm as the new weld's height. Set the convex type in the type field. 5 types are available for the shape of the weld. A new glyph identifying the chosen shape appears. The offset field is no longer grayed. Enter 1.5 mm as the height value for the convex surface of the weld. Note that the option weld symbol is on in the annotation tab, meaning that the annotation containing normalized symbols will be created. It is the default mode. To help you select the geometry you need, you can check the Selection Assistant option. This option displays a window showing you the geometric elements required to compute the weld. Zoom in to improve the view if need be. For creating fillet welds, you are prompted to select 2 adjacent surfaces. To close that window, just uncheck the option or click Close. Select the green face as the first surface. Select the blue face as the second surface. The name of the components you have just selected are displayed in the geometric elements section. Click the Type tab. This tab allows you to define if you want to create a simple weld, in fact a continuous weld, or a dashed weld make of serial beads of weld. Make sure that the simple type is selected. Click the Connection tab. Give a new name for the assembly joint. A joint is a set of the components which geometry is used for creating welds. For example, enter new joint in the assembly joint field. Click the Material tab to define the material you wish to assign to the fillet weld. Select copper from the material from catalog list. Click the Annotation tab to define the weld annotation. This tab allows you to define whether a weld annotation is created and associated with your weld. Options defined in this tab are persistent during the application session for other weld creation. Make sure that the weld symbol option is selected. When done, click OK to create the fillet weld. A warning message can appear to inform you that applicative properties have been added to the document. If you like, select the Do Not Show This Warning Again option and click OK. You must obtain this copper weld and this annotation. Optionally, right-click the annotation and select the Properties contextual command to edit the annotation's color. Then click the Graphic tab and set the color of your choice. examining the specification tree. Now that your first weld has been created, let's have a closer look at the specification tree. Let's have a look at product 2 node. Two new parts have been created and are displayed in hide mode. Copper product 2 new joined includes the geometry of the weld shape. Spec product 2 new joined includes the geometry used to compute the weld. Expand the assembly joints node. Assembly joints contains all the joints related to the parent product. New joined indicates both parts selected for locating the fillet weld. Joint body 1 gathers all joint elements. Weld 1 indicates the weld's name. Weld symbol 1 indicates the annotation. Copper indicates the material assigned to the weld. Expand the annotation set 1 node. Annotation set 1 contains all the annotations related to the parent product. Views gathers all annotations of the product. Front view 1 indicates the plane in which the application has located the annotation. Welds gathers all annotations of the product. Weld symbol 1 indicates the annotation. Creating a single V-butt weld with broad root face creation. This task shows you how to create another type of weld, namely a single V-butt weld with broad root face creation. Click the single V-butt weld with broad root face creation icon. Dialog box is displayed. Enter weld 2 to identify the new weld. Enter 5 mm as the weld's width. Enter 30 degrees as the weld's angle. Check the selection assistant option. If necessary, zoom in the view area to improve the view. The first selection text points to a face and an edge, meaning that you have the choice between selecting a face or an edge. Select the green face in contact with part 2. Note that the view area now shows the four selections required to weld the components. Select the brown face in contact with the face that you have just selected. Select the green part's top face as third face and brown part's top face as the last face. Check the option without propagation from the preparation mode category to determine how you want to remove material along the edges. Material will be removed just along the portion of edges used for making the bridge between the joining parts. Click the connection tab. Give a new name for the assembly joint. Enter single V-butt joint in the assembly joint field. Give a new name for the new joint body, single V-butt joint body for example. Click the Material tab to define the material you wish to assign to the fillet weld. Select copper from the material from catalog list. Click the Annotation tab to define the weld annotation. The previous created annotation view is pre-selected. Keep options as is. When done, click OK to create the single V-butt weld. The copper weld part as well as the corresponding annotation created. Note that the edges of the parts have been cut in a particular way. Let's check the specification tree again. Two new parts have been created and are displayed in hide mode. Copper product 2 single V-butt joined includes the geometry of the weld shape. Spec product 2 single V-butt joined includes the geometry used to compute the weld. Expand the assembly joints node. The assembly joints node now includes the new joint and its elements underneath. Expand the annotation set 1 node. The annotation set 1 node now includes a new element. Weld symbol 2 indicates the annotation. Examining the physical properties of the welds. This task shows you two ways of accessing information about the physical properties of the welds. Using the weld report command. Applying a material to a weld affects its physical properties. Just to check that, select the analyze. Weld report command. The report that appears is composed of two sections, list of welds and total of welds that includes shown information. Using the measure inertia capability. Click the measure inertia icon and select the desired weld in the specification tree, for example weld 1. The window that appears shows that different physical properties such as volume, mass, density, and so on of the weld have been calculated. Generating a view. This task is reserved for users who have a drafting license. It shows you what you need to do to quickly identify welds in the drafting workbench. Prior to entering the drafting workbench, right-click the copper entity and select the properties contextual command to define the view of the weld in the drafting workbench. Set the coloring and black options and the name as copper. Launch the drafting workbench by selecting start. Mechanical design. Drafting command and choose the option front, bottom and right layout option from the new drawing creation dialog box. The three views are generated. Use the offset section view icon to obtain a cutting profile. Double-click when the creation and position the section view. Use welding symbol icon to define both welds. First, select weld 1 and place the symbol. Make selections as shown and enter 5 as size of the weld. Now select the weld 2. Enter 9mm for size and make selections corresponding to the weld type. You have finished the welding design getting started tutorial. If you would like to receive news about new tutorials, please subscribe and open notifications.